Did you know about the longest dynasty of India? This is the Mughals, the Mauryas, the Marathas. We have studied them in our textbooks because of a very good reason. They were great empires. But there is one empire, one dynasty that our textbooks completely ignore. The Ahom dynasty. And in the next 3 minutes, I am going to give you 4 reasons why Ahom dynasty is worth your time. Number 1. For nearly 600 years, these kings controlled a great part of the northeast. These kings came from Burma and they settled near the river Brahmaputra in today's Assam. And the reason they could survive for 600 years is not because the king had unlimited power. Actually, it was exactly the opposite. There was a system in place to keep a check on king's power. The king would have 5 ministers and those ministers had the power to keep a check on the king and to make sure that the king is doing his job. They even had the power to remove the king if they thought that the king is not worthy. Number 2. Did you know that this small kingdom of Ahom defeated the Mughals 17 times? The Mughals, wo ek rajya nahi, ek samrajya tha. And at its peak, it had reached today's Bangladesh. During the period of Aurangzeb, the Mughal Empire was not a very tolerant empire. It was always either my way or the highway. And to save the culture of the Northeast, it was important to stop the Mughals. But why were the Mughals so interested in Assam? Because of this, the Brahmaputra River and its fertile region. This region is so fertile that even today people come over here and steal this mud. They literally steal mud and use it for farming. It's that good. Plus, by controlling the northeast, the Mughal could control the trade route to Eastern Asia. From 1615 to 1682, the Mughals attacked Assam countless times. In 1667, the Ahoms lost to the Mughals and this was a major blow to the Ahom Empire. Because the Ahoms had to pay 3 lakh as indemnity, they lost Guwahati, their capital. 2 Ahom princesses were taken by the Mughals as hostages. That was the reality of that era. The war did not end at the battlefield and the most vulnerable people suffered the most. Number 3. Lachit Borphukan is considered as one of the greatest army generals of all times in India. And the story of Ahom dynasty is incomplete without mentioning the Battle of Saraighat. Lachit Borphukan was the man who won back Guwahati from the Mughals. But instead of celebrating, he immediately started preparing for a counter-attack. He knew that the Mughals will not take their defeat so lightly because the Mughals were juggernauts. They were the bullies. So the Mughals came back with 30,000 infantry, 15,000 archers, 18,000 Turkish cavalry, 5,000 gunners and over 1,000 cannons. On a regular battlefield, defeating an angry Mughal force was next to impossible, but Lachit Borphukan was very, very smart. He used the geography to his advantage. He forced the Mughals to come in the river and the Mughal navy was their weakest link. For the Ahoms, the terrain became their biggest weapon. During the battle, at one point of time, Lachit Borphukan fell terribly ill and that brought down the morale of the entire army. So much so that they were thinking of retreating and this is what Lachit Borphukan said. If you want to flee, flee. The king has given me a task here and I will do it well. And they won the battle. He didn't fight for religion, he didn't fight for his leaders, he didn't fight for glory, but he fought for his land and he fought for his people. That's his greatness, and his greatness is celebrated in Assam every year on 24th of November as Lachit Diwas. Best cadet of NDA is given a gold medal in Lachit's name. Number 4. A part of India. What was so unique about the Ahom kings? It was that they were very tolerant towards all the religions. These kings, they came from outside, but they accepted a lot of Indian practices. And that's how they became a part of India. They didn't ruin and insult the existing culture. Instead, they added their flavor to the Indian culture by being a part of it. We call them the Seven Sisters, and yet we ignore our sisters. Their railroads, their floods, their incomplete bridges are their problems, right? You may not believe it, but racism exists in India. People from the Northeast are a constant target. They are called Chinki, Nepali, Chinese, Hakka Mughals so many times. Just recently, a Manipuri student was asked to show her passport to enter Taj Mahal. It might be an honest mistake, but how would you feel? Put yourself in her situation. How does it feel having no identity in your own country? So my question to our government is this. Why can't we introduce the culture of the Northeast in a very unique way, in an interesting way in our textbooks? Why don't we tell stories from the Northeast? So that the students from a very young age understand that the Northeast is a very crucial part of India. They need to understand the contribution of the Northeast to India and how important it is to preserve it. I need your help. Share this video and spread this message. Assam and the entire Northeast is an integral part of India. Their history, although not many people are aware about it, is something we should be proud of. Because without mentioning this history, the story of India is incomplete. And that's the reason why I love India.